Hello everyone, my name is John Melisandre and today I'm gonna teach you how to paint this wonderful landscape painting. It will not be easy for the beginners but it will be very challenging for them. And please don't forget to subscribe if you haven't subscribed it and hit that bell button if you want to receive some future notification of my new videos and tutorials. Okay everyone, so you can see all the materials needed in the screen. You can see all the 5 limited colors, the brushes, and other things that we're gonna need to paint this tutorial. Okay, so I'm gonna start now and I'm gonna do a little sketching first. Okay, so I have here this number 8 nylon flat brush and then this raw umber. Okay, so I will put the waterfalls here. I think I'm gonna put here on the slightly on the center. This will be kind of big waterfall. There. Yeah, make it. I think I'm gonna make it a little bigger. Longer there. Sorry, the horizon or the base of the waterfall, and then I'm gonna put some huge rock here. The rock here and here. I'll try to put a big tree here. There and then the sunrise here. Okay, and then on the back part I'm gonna put some trees, and here let's try to put, okay, so here. I'm gonna put one waterfall here. There. Some huge rocks, and then I'm gonna put I like to put lights there striking on this part. Also here some part of the cliff. Yeah, okay, so I will try to put some light here also. Yeah, and then here. Yeah, it will be good. Okay, so I think I'm gonna start now. Yeah, okay, so let's put first some under painting or backgrounds. So I'll just put white here with a little yellowish or orange yellow there. What I love about this canvas is just very, very smooth. Okay, now I'm going to use this blue color and A little red. Yeah, I'll just try to put some forest here on the back of this. Sorry everyone if there are plenty of noises on the background. Yeah, I'll just try to put more trees there in the back, or also I can put some pine trees. You can also put some pine trees like that. Okay. So we are just doing the underpainting, everyone. Yeah, and I have to hold it here because it's moving. So I'll just make it lighter here. Okay, there you go. And here I'm gonna make it dark. Yeah, I really miss a painting waterfall, everyone. Yeah. So I'll just use this dark with this raw amber. So this is another waterfall here. It will be a 2 waterfall. So I'll just cover it with the dark colors like this. But I want it to be a little mistier, a little misty or something like that. So I'm gonna make it lighter. Also put some grasses on the top, but it will be up to you, everyone. I'll just do it like this, dark something. Yeah. So here I'm gonna make it dark. So also remember everyone's sisters to mix the raw amber and blue and add a little white to make it not so dark. It's gonna be like this. We'll preserve the color. It's bad that if it's moving, everyone, it will be out of focus. So I need to hold this one. Just try to move a little, but not so light, everyone. Just make it not so dark and not so light. And here also, this will be some huge rock, but I'll just make it dark for now. Yeah, I need more paints. So I just have to mix the same colors all over again. Yeah, and then again this one, but I will try to do a little sketch. I'll put some guidelines here. This will be a rock here, and here this will be a big rock or something. Yeah, let's make it something like darker. On all my paintings, everyone, I really like to see those misty colors, misty backgrounds. I don't want to make my paintings so dark. I don't like it. I want it to be look like dramatic or something like that. So see, that's what makes a painting beautiful, is that there. So I'll just cover this rumber here. I mean waterfall. I'm sorry, everyone, it's not rumber. Okay, so what I like about misty colors is that it will make your painting more dramatic, more natural looking. Yeah, because you know when we see fogs that time, it looks really good for us. I like to see fogs also. It will make me feel like good or something. So on this river I will put some greenish blue green color for the background. So we'll just put the background colors first. Important that we do not see any light colors there. Yeah, I want also to put some colors like orange or brownish on the bottom. So here, I'll try to make some browns. And then this, you can make this brown. So I'll just cover everything with dark, everyone. Really long time to do this, but it's worth it, you know. I'll just make it a little faster. I need more blue. Yeah, painting really big canvas, everyone. It takes really time. Lots of time. So I just have to use this little bluish color for the background. There, so I think we're done with the underpainting. Yeah, so far I love it. And I think I will slowly start now the putting of colors or the details. So first I will just put some a tree here so that I have a guide. So it will be an orange tree. So that I have a guide here. And that will be here. That's it. Okay, so that I can remember that I will put three here. Okay, now I will slowly start. First, I think I'll just put first the waterfall here. Yeah, I will mix the raw umber with blue color. I'm using the number 8 flat brush, and then add some white. So this will be a waterfall here. So you can just do like that, so that it can create the water flow. Yeah, giant or big water flow, something like that. Here will be a big what are the star fans, and also here. Okay, and now I'm going to start adding the highlights, so it will be very, very bright. Highlights on the rocks or something. So here I have yellow, blue, amber, and the brown, and then I'm gonna put white. So here. So the light coming from here, it will spray to here. And then also here. This would be some solid rocks or something. Just try to put some very, very bright here. There, so you have no idea where you're gonna put those lights. And then I'll just put some light browns. It should be a little lighter. And of course here we need to put also, this part will be dark because there will be no lights. But we will make this lighter later. Painting waterfall, everyone. I think for a long time I didn't paint waterfall. There. Okay. I need also to put some greens, so I'll just use these greens here with white. To be bluish or greenish. Yeah, greens are like mosses or something. You can see on the sides of the waterfall. Okay, and now I'll put some yellow and white. A little red. Thank you. I think I need green, yellow and blue. Yeah, not just brown and brown, but you can also put greens. Okay. Yeah, I think I like it. Yeah, it looks good. Yeah, I need to put more white on the greens. Okay, now I need to lighten those light browns there. So here I have some yellow and red to make it orange and white. Now I will use this bristle flat brush here. Yeah, but first I'm going to put some highlights on the top. It will be some light yellow green, so and white. Can put more white. It should be bright enough, everyone. Can use the tapping technique. Make sure that the light is on the left side. Yeah, and I think I will put more light yellow on this part. See that there are some crosses there. Okay. And in here I'm gonna put some tree here. It will be some autumn tree. Yeah, it will be orange. Or some reddish tree. That's just the topping, everyone. And then on the back, I'll just use this blue with yellow to make some greens. It will be dark green with a little red. Okay. Yeah, and now I will pour more bright color here. I'll just use the white first, the yellow first for this part. You just put it on the tip, everyone. I will need to make sure that my brush is clean. And put a little grasses. That's it. or some yellow, just to see that this part is really glowing with colors. Okay. Yeah, I really like how the light striking on that part there. It's really look good. But I'll try to put light first on our dark waterfall. I'll put water first. White on the. I'll just use the bare plain white. Make sure that your brush is clean. Yeah. Yeah, something like that, but it's on the back line, so it should be just like that. And here also. You can do like that, like it's like falling. Okay. And in here we can put some glowing white. Just to make sure that these parts are really glowing bright. Okay. Yeah, I also miss painting like this, everyone. And then I'll try to put brighter colors there on this tree, but using this. To make it look more glowing. Okay. I'll just make this very bright. Sometimes acrylic colors, when it dry, it become the colors go down and they become darker. So you can put more colors until it become good bright color. Yeah, I think that looks good. Continue everyone, because I'm very excited to finish this. But this one here, I'm gonna make it brighter, a little brighter here, because I'm gonna put some sun rays here on this part. So I'm gonna do that part a little brighter. I'll just use this blue and a little blue amber with some white. I'll just make this part misty because I'll put the sunlight here. But I'm going to make this tree big and it will be large everyone, so that you can see it will cover some parts. So here I have white and I'll put some, now it will be a little brownish, and I will put some light here on this huge tree, rock. Yeah, I'm not done everyone, so I'm going to put more brownish, light brown or something. So I'll just use this raw amber. So here. Okay, I'm gonna put a little darker. You can also put some greenish color like this. Or darker. These dark colors also will give more depth. Okay, so as you can see, this part is a little lighter ever compared to this, so that's how you can create depths on your paintings. Okay, so here I'll try to put one tree here. Yeah, but I'm going to make this brighter later, everyone. The waterfall, so it's gonna be better to see. Okay, so I will make another tree here. Using this yellow. And yellow and this. Yellow and this bristle flat brush. Also put yellow here that it will look like glowing. There. I'll put yellow and white. Just slowly, everyone, tap it in the really bottom part, edge part or something. Should be in the edge. I love those trees there. And then I'm going to make some colors on the tree trunk. So this light up brown here. Okay. so far I really love this landscape, everyone. So I mean, it's not finished yet, but on this right side it's really looking good. And it's been a while, I never paint this kind of stuff like waterfalls, and it's really good. Okay, so I'm going to continue. Yeah. Okay, I will make this first misty, something like, and then I'm gonna make some. Yeah, I will make the water shallow, everyone. I like to paint shallow water like this here. So you can see there the rocks or whatever inside this river. So here I will be using some blue or umber. Yeah, I'll just make this part darker. So I'm gonna put big rock here or something like that. Yeah, maybe no, I will not put rock here. I just put some pathway here, something. Yeah. When you paint, everyone, you should always visualize what are you going to put there, because it will affect the whole painting. You should also do not put so crowded things there, like many things. So here, there, I'll just make the color solid. And also here, it will be darker. Okay, I will try to put some few rocks there, but I will put light here, everyone, so it will be yellow and blue and a little white. Something like this, just a little lighter compared to the dark background, everyone. And then I will try to put lighter browns on the bottom, yellow, red, and umber, and then white, more yellow. This will be some Purex. There. Yeah, it should be a lot more darker, but I'm gonna also to put some light greens. Yeah, some light greens. Just to create it look like there's rocks there on the bottom, big and small rocks. Cause it hasn't been hit by the sunlight, so we can do it everyone like this. Yeah, it's almost 1 hour, everyone, and it's fine. I'm also almost done. Okay. I'm gonna refine this witch rock there, but I'm going to put some white, some raw amber, and this amber and this blue. Put some dark there on the bottom. I also put some greenish color there, so blue and yellow and red. I'll put some light yellow or light green. And then I'll try to put some more like dark brownish thing here. So it'll become a huge rock. But I also need to put some so I'm gonna put more brownish. Just put more brownish, everyone. And then a little bluish. Yeah. Okay, we have a rock, beautiful rock. Yeah, it's been 1 hour, everyone, and I'm still in this part. Okay, but so far it looks good, and I'm gonna put some light here. That is, but I'm going to make this part a little dark, like bluish something, bluish brown. For them, some shadow, everyone, or casted shadow, something. I also need to put some raw amber and blue to make the bottom dark. Okay, so we can see now those shadows, and then I'm gonna put some under rocks under the river, so I can put some small rocks like that. And then I think I will try to put some under orange under colors or something. I'm going to make it a little lighter also. Okay. That looks good. Okay, and then I'll try to make this waterfall lighter. I'll just use this blue here with the red to make it purple and white. Okay. Just don't make it too straight, everyone, on this. And I'm using lighter purple. Just you mix the red and blue to make it like this. And then do not forget this reflection here. Just drag it down. Make sure that your brush is wet. It's dry, I mean. Then create some vertical strokes like this. To create some small ripples. Okay, and also here, everyone. But I will make some disturbance here first. Love it, everyone. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to continue more. So here on this part, I'm going to put some land here, something like that. Sorry, but if I'm blocking you in your view. Okay. It's 1 hour and 10 minutes, and yeah, I'm enjoying this video because I love the result. Okay, so here I'm going to put some dark. Riverbank. In this one here, I'm gonna make it dark. There. Okay. And of course, this one, it should have some rocks or something. Yeah, you can see here the rocks on the bottom. So I like this color, like these things there. Also, I'm gonna put some dark spots on this rock. Okay. Yeah. It's really good, everyone. Yeah, I'm going to finish it now, maybe. Yeah, it takes really time. I'm going to paint the tree there, the red tree there on the left side. Okay, so I'm going to paint now. I'm going to get closer and then I'll put the tree trunk first here. Yeah. Raw umber and chest blue to create a dark tree trunk. Yeah. Maybe I'll just use the raw umber. There. And then some branches. There. And then I'm going to use the bristle flat brush. I'm going to put the red color first. Just topping everyone. There. Okay, So you have now some huge red tree here. And then I'm going to put some highlights on the background part of the, so I'll just use this yellow and white. Color should be on the back, everyone, because it's like a backlight there. Okay, and then I'll try to put some highlights. So I'll be just using this liner brush and white color, and I'm gonna put some highlights there. This tree. There. I'll try to use this yellow and white. Okay, and then I'll use this yellow because I'm gonna put some grasses also here. Should be very bright, everyone, because the light is coming from the left side, from the this top, call this part. Yeah, so far, everyone, it's really, really good. Yeah. Okay, I will continue adding more. Thank you. process using this maybe I will put more using the Prisol flat brush. But I'll put first some orange like that. Okay, I know I'm going to use this orange here as I try to create some a little colors or highlights there, some orange highlights for this tree. But I think I need more yellow. Okay, just orange everyone. Not just orange, but also I think I'm going to put some greenish color there. Yellow and blue. I think I like the tree there in the left side. Okay, so I think I'm going to put the sun rays now and just a little retouch and I think I'm done. And what I see here is really really good painting. And I think it will be easy for you also. Okay. You need to dry your brush, everyone. Just use this brush, number 8 flat brush. You can also use bristle, but the most important thing is it should be dry. Okay. Use this brush and I use this color here. It's a light blue color and I'm gonna put the light coming from here. Yeah, I think that will be fine. And then I'll use a small brush. Then this yellow here. And red. And then white. So I think it will be here. I'll be using some white. Just make this very bright here. Okay. Yeah, I think that looks good. And I'm going to retouch now. I'm going to put some glowing colors. So I'll be using the white here. Just create, let's put some white there. And then also here. Let's just put some water reflection. No, it's wrong, everyone. Yeah, I think it's not. It's wrong. It should be like here. There. Okay. I'll put more white here. Okay, but I think I will put more rocks here on the bottom. Okay, everyone, so I think I am in the process of retouching, and I will retouch everything just to make sure that it will always look good. I'll use this a little orange color. Thank you. here. I'm gonna put some more orange. This will be under. These are the rocks under the river, everyone. Because there's a light here, it will always usually strike also here. See, okay. This shallow part, you can see mostly all the rocks there. Okay, I forgot to put the shadow. Dark green. So I'm mixing for the dark green, and I'll put the shadow here. Just use this raw umber and blue. Okay. It's 1 hour and 30 minutes, everyone, and so far I'm enjoying the result. It's good. Yeah, it looks good. Okay, I really like the bright light there. Yeah, I'll just put birds. Yeah. Okay, so that will be my last part on this one, putting some part. But everyone, I'm going to make this one darker here. And then some lighter brown. And then I'm going to use smaller brush. So here I'll be using some white, and then I'm gonna put a bird here. I'm using the liner brush, everyone. Okay, that will be a bird, a big bird. And I'm going to mix for a darker color. And I'm going to put the one bird here. It'll be here. Like this brush, everyone. That's not good. So the reflection. Okay. Yeah, I think I am done, everyone. It's 1 hour and 40 minutes, and yeah, I will just retouch something, just a small retouch, and I'll be finished and everything. Okay, so yeah, I think I'm contented, and I really love the result here. It's really good. It looks pretty realistic in my eyes. So yeah,
okay, everyone, so I want to say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praises always belongs to the Lord.